Your party enters the dungeon.
A dungeon? Really?
Ugh, Garcat.
Yes, really a dungeon.
And what? Is there gonna be a dragon there too?
Of course there are going to be dragons. I love dragons. My freaking mom was a dragon. An RPG without a dragon is like a good time without one of your shit fits. It's inconceivable.
Who decided to make you game master anyway? No, I'm good, thank you. I really am good.
Trezzy is the only one among us with any role-playing experience of the sort that's played on a tabletop, in any case. I do agree that, as a setting, a dungeon is rather droll.
Speaking of which, I'm surprised everyone else found the time to peruse the many volumes in which the guidelines were written.
We didn't. We're gonna figure it out as we go along.
Fine. All right. Your adventure begins inside a dragon's belly.
Oh, come the fuck on!
Let's review the party roster. First, there's Stave's dwarf knight.
Whoa! A knight?
Jesus Christ.
He can't be a knight, I'm already a knight.
Cockat, if you're concerned about variety, our party could more than tolerate two knights. Perhaps they may even be differentiated with the possession of distinct... builds.
I'm not going to budge on this.
Alright, I'll just make another character if it'll get you to shut up.
No! I'm sorry, Dave, but Cockat is never going to learn if we keep giving in to his stupid, grubby tantrums. Cockat, you can either stop playing with us, or you can be quiet for once in your life and use this backup character sheet I've prepared. Your choice.
Fine.
So, Dave's got a neutral good dwarven knight.
Why a dwarf?
Name one bad dwarf.
I don't think I can name any.
Don't break my heart like this, Lalonde. I know you watched Lord of the Rings.
And Carcat's playing as a true neutral, half undead, half uneaten crab sandwich. Rose is a human wizard, notably male.
I've always thought that a role-playing game should serve as a good opportunity to explore identities which are otherwise alien to oneself.
Is that why you chose chaotic evil as your alignment?
No.
And Kenaya. Kenaya, you can't roll a demon temptress from the underworld as lawful good.
Huh. I've read the guide thoroughly. I am certain it is allowed.
Not at the beginning of the game. It goes against the integrity of the setting.
Don't worry, Kenaya. Your seductress can still act against her alignment.
But according to the rules, that would require a role-playing scenario of significant convolution.
Perhaps one in which a magician of great power finds himself enamored by a spirit of equally great beauty, and thus strives to better himself in the hopes of pulling her out of the hell in which he was born.
That would be a captivating story.
An enthralling narrative.
An utterly enchanting...
Barf! Holy shit, can we start the game already?
Let the record show that for the first time in months, Cockat and I actually managed to agree on something. In regards to both the game's commencement, and especially the barf.
You guys want to alchemize some pizza and watch a movie instead?
Oh, thank God. I was afraid nobody would say anything.
I've got a dang Cook film I've been wanting to see.
How much of your library would we need to look through to find something without Dane Cook in it?
All of it.